Hey, this is Spider-Crow, and this is part two of The Blood of the Rhodes. Because I was so excited, I needed to continue almost immediately. Anyway, here we go. Once I get close enough to my desk, because apparently my chair doesn't like me. Ta-da! Look, it's Alfred. Adulting is not going to be a thing I'm good at. What to do? Let's read the journal. Yeah. Can I walk into the beds? Can't go under the covers. It's not bedtime. You can't sleep yet. No, I am adventuring through their house. There is a selection of books lined up on the shelves. Some of them are cookbooks from Francis. Matthew loves reading. Sounds like something Matthew would do. This is a painting of a bouquet of flowers in a vase. It was painted by Gran. Her name is signed at the bottom. This painting is beautiful. I remember that she told me she was taught how to do drawings and paint by a young man. She didn't remember who, but he was a gentleman at the time. I swear to God, this is the prince that went missing. I swear to cow. Why do I do this to my brain? Nah. She felt sad because he disappeared 50 years ago. The time of the murders! Let's bug Matthew. Alfred, I'm busy over here. Sorry, bro. I can't go upstairs. Well, I guess it's nap time. Yes, we're taking a nap now. We are taking a nap. I have chips. Al! Al, wake up! Matthew, that is so mean. Why'd you slap your brother? About time. Oh, hey, bro.
Lazy twat.
Good to see you up, Al. The pie is ready. Sweet! I'm hungry! You never change, Al. Are we going to eat food? Is it acceptable? About an hour later. It takes an hour for them to eat food. I'm not judging. It actually takes me a hellish lot longer. Man, this pie is delicious. I'm glad you like it. Listen, Al. I'm sorry about earlier. It's alright, dude. I was a jerk. I shouldn't have had a go at you. But... what's wrong, Matthew? I know the villagers said they wouldn't mention anything about what happened, but I can understand why you want to know more. Oh? Since Gran made it clear she didn't want to tell you, you can ask me about it instead. Exclamation point! Are you sure? Yes, it's fine. You can ask me anything. Go ahead. The family, the mob attacks, after the attacks. Let's ask these in order if we're going to ask them all. So let's start with the family. I seriously hope we're going to ask them all because I need all of this information. All of it is needed. Could you tell me about the family? Sure. The family that owned this land were known to have been kind and caring to all of the villagers that they've known. They were respected and blessed by everyone. The king and queen were known to have helped many of the villagers with their needs. A lot of villages, including this one, had scenery and wildlife protected by them too. The king and queen themselves had children, two sons and a daughter. Some people said that the environment and wildlife was protected for another reason, because the children loved the scenery. Nice, it would have been great if we had a chance to meet them.
Oh, you're asking all of them.
All of the questions! Why did the mobs attack them in the first place? After the queen died, the family was devastated. The news shocked the whole kingdom as well. It has been said that the villagers thought she died of illness, but after that, one man claimed the queen was killed, and the family was trying to hide it. No way. Well, whether it was true or not, the man gathered a few of the villagers that were angry with this crime. Then they marched into the woods to locate the family's home. They slaughtered the children and anyone who tried to protect them. What about the king? Apparently he went missing. The family home was transformed from a haven into a bloodbath. Oh my god. Yeah, this isn't something people talk about. Why do you know this? After the attacks. It's the only question left. I want to eat chips. What happened after the attacks?
Well, the man who led the mobs took control of the kingdom as the new king, while the mobs themselves went on and celebrated their deeds. The villagers, however, were not happy, especially those that went and found the bodies of the dead family. It didn't take long for someone to discover what had happened. The mobs and the king were marked as traitors and were sentenced to death. You could say they were severely punished.
What about Gran?
Gran stayed in another village to avoid the incident. She didn't return until it died down. After that, no one went to that house ever again.
Oh god. I'm very worried about what he's gonna say. Hey, dude.
What?
I've got a great idea. Fuck. I have a theory that there's more to the story. Then I would go to this house and find out more about it. Al, it's too dangerous. Dangerous or not, I am the hero. I laugh at the face of danger.
Oh, Alfred, you make so many things so much fun.
But still, this is stupid. You'll get yourself into trouble. Who cares? Besides, even if I do get into trouble, I'd rather find out the truth than act like it's another silly story. Then I'm coming too. You're going to need someone to keep you out of trouble.
Really? Because it sounds like you're just getting into trouble with him.
But Matthew, you told me this was dangerous. I don't want you to get hurt. Wow, I switched their voices up for a second. We are brothers. We do things together. I won't let you go alone. Yes, I can't change your mind. All right then, Matt. We will sneak out in the morning. Sound good?
Yeah.
The truth was, a part of me didn't want Matthew to go. No matter how many times I tried, he refuses to leave my side. I'm seriously worried about his safety. But no matter what happens, I will protect him. I will protect my brother. His fate is in my hands.
Woo!
The next day,
it supposed to be a black screen or is something fucking up?
Are you ready?
Yep, I'm ready when you are.
Hey, Matt, are you sure about this? You know, we're in big trouble if Francis finds out.
For now, I don't really care. I'm going where you're going.
Alright, bro, let's go. It's not gonna end well.
We just fucking teleported.
Whoa, this place is huge. You've been here before.
This place is really creepy.
Aw, is my little brother Bear scared of this place?
Aw, he calls him Brother Bear. It's so adorable.
No, it's not like that at all.
I just...
Look, Matthew. We can just have a little look around and then go home. How does that sound?
Okay.
Alright, let's go!
Holy crap, he disappeared. Ah, it's working again.
We're all going to die. Whoa, look at this place. It's really old. No duh!
Al, can we go now? This place is scary.
Oh, come on. Where's your sense of adventure?
As far as I know, he's more of a I'm going to survive kind of person, not a let's wander into this place and hopefully not die.
That is what Alfred is. Alfred is a person who's just like, we're going on an adventure, winds up dead 3 years.
Anyway, back to the game. Sidetrack. Well,
broken glass!
Aww.
What was that?
I don't know.
Wow. Matthew, stay here while I check it out.
Okay. You'll come back, won't you?
I promise. Stay here. Oh, shit. I'm gonna save now because, well, I just don't want to die. Wrong button, stupid. Wait, what is this? Damn it, I can't get it to open.
We're all gonna die.
Doesn't look like anything happened here.
Help! Matthew!
Wow,
Matthew!
Because I don't want to shout right now. Fucking teleport. Come on, dude, you're supposed to teleport.
Matthew, you're not supposed to leave!
Matthew! Where are you?
No.
This is not happening. This can't be happening.
It's Matthew's glasses.
Oh no. Where could you have gone? I'll keep these safe for you. Obtained Matthew's glasses. You know, I kind of figured Alfred was going to be the one to die, but okay. Also, what happened to the never go anywhere alone thing? Gooder, if you go into any weird house, you don't be alone. It's not an okay thing. Wait for me, brother. I'll find you and get us out of here. I promise. Chapter 2, The Lost Boy. That's fucking England. Well, if this would stop us... Okay. So, I kind of think it's a good spot to end it here for now. We'll see you next time. And hopefully we will find Matthew or something. Because, what the heck? Also, you're supposed to be smart. Why would you leave Matthew alone? Anyway, see you next time. Bye.